Com. All right, in just over a week, it's hard to believe we will be in November, which is Epilepsy Awareness Month. And today we're talking about deep brain stimulation and epilepsy. Joining us live is Dr. Gabriel Martz, Medical Director of the Epilepsy Center at Hartford Healthcare's AIR Neuroscience Institute. Doctor, welcome.
Hi, thanks.
So what is epilepsy and what are the symptoms?
Epilepsy is really defined by having seizures that aren't caused by something else. And unfortunately, a lot of other symptoms sometimes come along with that, particularly people who aren't able to control their seizures with medications. Most people can, but some can't. And that leads to problems like being less likely to finish college, less likely to finish high school, less likely to get married, less likely you can drive, all kinds of other symptoms that go along with it when you have what's called refractory epilepsy, which is a troubling problem. When you have two medications that you've tried and you're still having seizures, that's refractory. So someone who has, you know, a few seizures a year might get used to living with that, but we'd rather see you and try to help you stop having seizures and all the other things that go along with it to really maximize your life goals.
All right, so tell us the purpose of deep brain stimulation and who would be a good candidate for it.
Yeah, so folks who are on medicines and still having seizures, as I said, refractory epilepsy, we try to find any way we can to maximize life goals. And a major part of that is trying to stop the seizures that keep happening. And we think medicines can be helpful, but if not, there's other surgical options. There's a wide range of surgical options. And what we want to do is offer you every chance to get those seizures stopped. And so we have a variety of team members that look through your case to figure out what is the best way to stop them, pick what kind of surgery might be the safest for you, as well as the most effective for you. And we're very excited to be able to offer deep brain stimulation because it's the type of surgery that's been around only a couple of years, and it gives people an option who didn't have an option before. Even though, you know, a variety of surgical options, one, there may not be one that's best for you, but this one can work where others can't.
Interesting. So tell us, how does it work?
Yeah, so what we do is we place electrodes in a very deep part of the brain, which is why it's called deep brain stimulation. And those electrodes are in the thalamus. And the thalamus is sort of like the central control center for the brain in a way. So even if we don't know exactly where the seizures are coming from, by sort of using the central systems of the brain, we can try to provide a pacemaker rhythm to these deep parts that tell the rest of the brain to kind of calm down and stop having as many seizures. And that's, you can almost think of it like if a cell tower telling all the phones to calm down, all the phones that might be connected to that tower. So that's how it works. We put electrodes deep in the brain, and then we attach that to a battery pack that's in the chest, and it gives, much like a cardiac pacemaker, it gives a stimulation every few minutes to help the brain to calm down a little bit and have fewer seizures.
All right, Dr. Gabriel Martz, thank you very much for being with us and informing us. It sounds so interesting.
My pleasure.
Thank you.